The just concluded Uganda Matters Day celebrations at Namgongo attracted over 1 million pilgrims at both the Anglican and the Catholic sites. According to the Uganda Police Force, the celebrations were a great success, except for a few cases reported.
The popular celebrations passed without any major incident or threats. From our policing standpoint, there were very few incidents. We registered about 199 cases over a period of 7 days. That is from the 28th of May, when we started deploying at the various venues, up to the 4th of June.
Enanga reveals that there are still some pilgrims stranded at the Catholic site. However, police are working with the church to have them transported back to their homes.
As of yesterday, we still had about 22 pilgrims at the Catholic site who were still stranded, and we were making arrangements with the transport sector to see how they can get transported back to their places of origin. So the organizers of the event.
Meanwhile, Kampala Metropolitan Traffic Commander Rogers Nsereko reveals that they also registered a number of road crashes involving the pilgrims. These claimed several lives and left others seriously wounded. Dozens of vehicles were also impounded for violating traffic guidelines during Matters Day celebrations. Meanwhile, the police have confirmed the arrest of Dr. Ismail Kalule following reports that he was involved in making improvised explosive devices. According to police spokesperson Fred Enanga, Dr. Kalule is currently held by the Chieftains of Military Intelligence, CMI, on allegations that he is involved in rebel activities.
So he's under investigation under CMI, and also for his alleged connection into previous incidents of terrorism.
Enanga also reveals that last week they raided the home of Sheikh Yunus Kamoga and arrested over 30 people. It is said that Sheikh Kamoga was illegally conducting Islamic lessons at his home.
There were around 32 other youth and young adults, all male, at this training center. So the motive of the sacred training, which is restricted to male youth and adults inside an enclosed facility, which was locked, we found over 6 padlocks across all the gates.